Coders, my name is Shawn, and I will be your instructor today. This is Lesson 3 of the series, Python for Beginners. In this lesson, we will learn about errors, learn about basic operators, including addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, floor division, the modulus operator, and the exponent. If you have not heard about some of these, rest assured I will teach you from scratch. So getting into it, one of the first things you may have realized is that I am on the Mac operating system this time, whereas I am generally on the Windows operating system. Now the main reason for this is because you guys gave me a lot of suggestions and complaints that I was only using Windows, and that you wanted to see me use Linux or Mac at some point. So, as far as PyCharm is concerned, the different operating systems do not really make a difference, and I would say the only even partially major difference would be the shortcuts. For example, if I put Coding with Shawn in our proper print bracket, Coding with Shawn, and then I went to run it, as you can see, the shortcut, at least on Mac, is Control and R. If you're using Windows, you will know that the shortcut is Shift Command F10. And if you're using Linux, it is likely something completely different. So let's go ahead and get started. The first thing we're going to be covering are errors. So humans are very, very prone to making mistakes. And unfortunately, humans are also typically in charge of creating programs. So to compensate, Python and a lot of other programming languages attempt to understand and explain mistakes made in their programs. So Python, at least, refers to these mistakes as errors, and will point to the location where an error occurred with a caret character. For the guys who do not know what a caret character is, it is this character right there. So, when programs throw errors that we did not expect to encounter, programmers call those errors bugs. Programmers call the process of updating the program so that it no longer produces the unexpected errors debugging. If you really knew the word debugging, but just learned what the actual meaning of it was today, please leave a comment down below, because I know a lot of people did. When it was my first day coding, I learned what debugging meant that day too, and I was like, oh, so that's what it means, because it seems like everyone knows the word, but literally no one except for programmers knows the meaning. So there are two common errors that we encounter while writing Python, and those are the syntax error and the name error. The syntax error means there is something wrong with the way your program is written, such as punctuation that does not belong, a command where it is not expected, or a missing parentheses can all trigger a syntax error. So for example, if I put print my parentheses, I do not put the quotes, then I put coding with Shawn, and then I run my program. As you can see, it has thrown me a syntax error, said invalid syntax, put a caret up to where it shows the line, and shows me the file, and manually tells me what line number it is. So that is basically the basics of the syntax error. Now what's a name error? So the way I like to show this is actually just putting pint instead of print, and then putting your parentheses, properly putting your quotes this time, your single or your double quotes, putting whatever you want in the middle, and then when you run your code, as you can see, Python has thrown you a name error. The name pint is not defined. The reason for the difference is because the previous time, we had forgotten to put quotes, which are part of Python syntax. Pint, on the other hand, Python does not recognize the meaning of that, and it is not a variable that was previously specified. Therefore, Python says it's a name error. So those are really the basics of errors. Moving on, we're going to cover our basic operators today. So our basic operators, as I said in the introduction, are addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, floor division, the modulus operator, and of course your exponent. So you may not be used to how Python really covers these operators and how it executes them, because you may not think of it the same way yourself on paper or in your mind as Python actually does execute it. So the way Python really runs its code are, you would put print, your parentheses. You would not want to put quotes if you are trying to get an answer to a equation. Then you would put your equation. So we're going to go ahead and start with addition. So go ahead and put 2 plus 2 in the middle. Then we're going to run the code. And as you can see, it has put 4. If you do not put the print operator and you just go 2 plus 2 and then you try to run it, as you can see, Python does not throw an error because this is a completely valid equation, but you have not told Python that you want to get an answer to it. So the next operator we're going to cover is subtraction. Subtraction is very, very similar to how addition works. You again just put it in your print statement. You're going to go ahead and put your 2, minus 2 this time with your minus character. And then you run it again. As you can see, it has thrown you a 0. And just to show you that this actually does work, if I put 6 minus 2 and I ran it, again, you get the proper answer. Now the thing is, Python is far faster than humans are at calculating. So if I put print, and then I put, you know, any really number, and then I put something else, this will probably take us about 20 minutes to do in our mind. Maybe even far more than that. That's really an understatement. Python, on the other hand, takes seconds. This is really one of the reasons why these programming languages are so powerful and so commonly used. So, moving on, our next operator will be multiplication. Now, as a kid, and really even as an adult, you may often use your multiplication operator as, let's do it and put 7, and then you're generally going to, not generally, but possibly you put x a lot of the time. Well, x is not going to work here. Why? Because Python does not recognize that as a valid alias for the multiplication operator. Because Python thinks that you're either putting a variable or you're really you just got a name error. So that's what Python interpreter and Python are going to think. So you're always going to want to make sure that you put it in your print statement, and then you put 7, and then the star, which is the multiplication character in Python, and then your next number. So we're just going to go ahead and put 7. When you run your program, as you can see, you get the proper answer. Moving on to division. Division, again, is very, very similar. However, it also is very, very different. As a kid, you may have been taught to use division as the little circle, then the line, then the circle again at the bottom. Well, that's not how Python works, it obviously. In Python, you're going to want to put 5, assuming that 5 is your first starting a number, you're going to put 5, then a slash, which actually represents the division operator, and let's go ahead and put 7. Obviously, we're not going to get a whole number, and as you can see, despite that being such a complicated equation for us to do in our minds, Python did it in a split second. I don't even want to say split second. I want to say split of a split second. That's how powerful Python is, guys. If you learn Python, it's going to be so helpful for your career or your hobbies or whatever, guys. So please stay tuned with me until the end of this lesson, or rather, this entire course. So, okay. Now we're getting into some things that you may not have actually heard of or did before. The first one of these is actually going to be floor division. So what floor division does is it rounds down the answer to the nearest whole number. So let's go ahead and actually try our other equation that we just did representing division. That was 5 divided by 7. If we do run that, by the way, I might as well mention, for the floor division, you're going to put 2 slashes. That is the only representation of the floor division character in Python. 5 divided by 7, then you're going to run your program. As you can see, the nearest number to that 0.07 or whatever that was. Go ahead and check. Yes, as you can see, the closest number to that backwards would be 0. Okay, next operator is going to be modulus. Modulus is not something that you're taught in your 7th grade math class. Modulus is one of these more complicated things that you may not have actually heard of before. So what this does is that it gives the remainder of your division problem. And if we do a proper division equation, so let's go ahead and do 5 divided by 2. Well, this is 5 divided by 2, am I right? So we're going to have to put our modulus operator to get our modulus answer. And the only representation, again, for the modulus operator is going to be that parentheses symbol. So you're going to do that, then you're going to run your program, and as you can see, the closest number to that is going to be 1 as far as modulus is concerned. So the next operator is going to be the exponent. The exponent, we all know what the exponent is for the most part. The exponent is just to the power of. So you're going to do, like, for 5 to the power of 2, you're obviously going to get 25. And Python can confirm that by your 2 multiplication operators. So you're going to have to be really careful when you're multiplying or using the exponent operator to make sure that you do not get those two confused. Because if you have a 1 multiplication operator symbol, you're going to have to multiply. If you have 2 or more, you're going to always it's always going to be the exponent. So if you do know how you can do 5 to the power of 2 and to the power of 2, that's why you can do multiple multiplication operators and still get an answer. Let's go ahead and test our 5 to the power of 2, and as you can see, we get 25 as expected. So that's going to be it for this video, at least. I do want to cover one more thing, though, before I say bye-bye, and that's going to be our errors, at least as far as these operators go. So Python has its one major special error that it has that is, as far as I know, only in Python. And what that is the zero division error. If you do incorrectly run it, what it will show as is zero division error, as you can see right there. So if we do 5 divided by 0 and then we try to run that, as you can see, it has given us our zero division error, division by 0. And then it gives us our line, our manual line, and our file. Okay, so that's going to be completely it for today. I really hope you enjoyed. I really hope you learned something. If you did learn something and you did like the video, then please go ahead and leave a like for the video. Please share this video. And if you do like what you're learning here, please also subscribe. So I hope to see you next time. And until then, farewell.